This screencast is to go over some design considerations when teachers are designing for students who may be using the Canvas student app on a device such as an iPad. So when students are using the Canvas student app, an issue appears to be that if there is a blend item, like a page, a quiz, an assignment, a discussion board, if that blend item is not in a published module, students using the Canvas student app cannot see it. So a solution or workaround is to remember that Blend is Canvas, meaning that students who do use the Canvas student app can also access Blend by opening a browser and going to their student portal and then finding Blend here. So right now I am on a laptop and I have my Chrome browser open. I can access Blend by going to the portal after pulling up a browser. And when I click on Blend, it takes me right there. Students on a device such as an iPad have the Canvas student app downloaded there, and that's how many of them may be accessing your course. So when we consider how we design for students, we want to design for both parties who may be using a browser and just going to the portal and clicking on Blend that way, or students who prefer to use the Canvas student app, which has been the most streamlined way for students to access their Blend courses. So no matter what method they are using to access Blend, we want to design for both parties in mind. So I'm in a Blend course here, and when I go to modules, this is a reminder that students can only see content when using the Canvas student app if the item is in a published module. So all these items that are published are visible to students when they are linked from somewhere. However, these two items here, these, even though they are published, they are part of a module that has not yet been released for students. So even if I link this for students, they will get access denied. For example, when I right click and copy link address, I'm going to go to student view to see what a student sees. I'm going to click here on student view, and I'm actually going to open a new tab in my Chrome browser, and I'm going to type that in. Notice that in student view, it gives me access denied. And again, it's because it's part of a module that has not yet been published. So I'm going to leave student view. And what Blend does is it takes me to the page that was giving students access denied so that I can troubleshoot. And again, I can see that the page has correctly been published. But when I refresh here and go to the teacher view and then go to modules, I can see that even though my page is published, it exists in a module that is not published. I'm also noticing that there is a dash 2 here, which tells me it's a copy of the item. So the easiest way to add something to a module is to go to the module you want to add something to, click on the plus button, and then here is a drop-down menu. Blend categorizes the different types of things that you can add to a module, including Blend assignments, Blend quizzes, Blend files, Blend pages, and so on. I can add new items right here into the module by clicking on the first selection here, or I can go to things that I've already created. So for example, the sock ball item was a Blend page. And so when I click on the drop-down menu to select pages, it first alphabetizes it by emoji, and then it alphabetizes it by first letter of the title. So here I can see two sock ball items. It looks like this was a duplicate. So I can just add the first iteration of this by clicking on the item and clicking add item. If I accidentally added it to the incorrect module, I can just click here and I can click remove. So I'm going to remove it from the module. But note that because you have two sock balls now, they are probably different links. So yes, you will need to relink after adding it to the module. When I look at these items here, let me open them in new tabs. This is sockball. I'll open that in a new tab. This is sockball 2. Notice that they are different URLs, because if I highlight the title up here, this is sockball throwing lesson in games. This is sockball lesson in games 2. So you will need to relink and make sure it's linking to the correct item that is in a published module. And the easiest way to do that is, again, to go to modules, to click on the plus button, to add it and make sure it's published, and then right click and copy that link.